Now, obviously, I'm the big bullhorn for prep schools, and you are too, because you've been in that world, but you also do other scouting as well. Now that you've been out in the world and been a D1 coach, been a D3 coach, been at a prep school, have a scouting report, why don't you give folks out there that are listening, like, what's the biggest difference between a prep school player versus like a normal high school player? Stereotypically.
Well, yeah, I think, so my take on prep schools is a little, maybe a little different, because I think there's a lot of room for nuance. You know, there's nuance in where you go to prep school. You know, the experience, let's just take where I was. There was a vast difference in the kids who played for me year one at Choate when I had one Division III player versus at year eight when I was done, you know, my last 4 years there, everybody who got on, you couldn't get on the court if you weren't a college player. And you probably weren't in the starting lineup unless you were a scholarship caliber player. And that was in the third best league in the NEPSAC. So I think and you know, quite frankly, there's other prep schools. I mean, there's six divisions in the NEPSAC. The NEPSAC is the New England Athletic Prep, get all the letters mixed up, but it's basically the New England Prep League. And, you know, if you're in Class D, most kids aren't college players. So I think but if you're in AAA and you're at a Brewster, Northfield, Mount Hermon game, then everybody's a Division I player. So I think there's a lot of room for nuance. But if you're talking about the high-end levels of prep school basketball, which I think most people are, I think the biggest difference is just the level of competition. One of the things I get quite a lot is, you know, people say, oh, you're biased towards the prep schools. And I said, I'm biased to where the players are. And the players are statistically in the prep schools, at least in the area of the country I'm from. Obviously, there's a big geographic component to that. But in New England, that's just been that's been the way the landscape has evolved over the years. But I'm not, just to clarify, I'm not a believer that prep school is right for absolutely everyone. I'm not a believer that every prep school is, you know, if you can go, not everyone who can go to any school should automatically, not everyone can play at Brewster Academy, quite frankly. You know, Jason himself would tell you, I think he coined the phrase, there's a thin line between exposure and exposed. And right. There, you know, so you have to find the right fit for you. I think fortunately, prep schools have grown and are growing geographically into different parts of the country where there is a fit for everyone. So you can figure out athletically what you want and what you need, because they aren't necessarily the same thing. Academically, what you're looking for, geographically, what you're looking for, put all those things together, and there is there's probably a school for you. I mean, I think that's probably the biggest thing for me is when someone calls and says, you know, I'm looking for a prep school, what do you recommend? I usually respond with the question of, well, what are you looking for? What's the academic criteria? What's the athletic criteria? Do you want to play with the best players, or do you want to go to the place where you're going to be at the most, get the most playing time? So there's a lot of nuance to it, I think. And so I don't think it's necessarily the one size fits all, but at the high levels, there's no denying that it is at least where I'm from, a higher level of competition than you see in the state associations on average.
Yeah.